I have to tell you that already 10 years ago, we introduced art in leadership development in our school. So our school is built on three main pillars. Ethics, we introduced ethics already, we are now 30 years existing. So we were the first management school in all Eastern Central Europe. And ethics is there already in the program. I can't say since the beginning, but like 4 years after the beginning of the school, we established it. So that means about 26 years ago, we had ethics as a required subject in MBA curriculum. Then we came with sustainable development. We have sustainable development already for 10 years. We have also Coca-Cola chair for sustainable development. And so in our MBA curriculum again, and also in other educational programs, we have sustainable development as one of the, again, a required subject. And you have to make exam out of it, and you have really to pay attention to this subject in the school and later, we hope, in the business. And the third one, and probably the strongest one, where we are really differentiating ourselves, is also 10 years old, it's art and leadership. We are understanding that art can, and not understanding, but doing that. And why? Where is the work in progress? Is that we shall have this year, in September, September 1st to the September 4th, to September 4th, we shall have an international academic conference on art and leadership, AOMO called. So you are kindly invited, of course, to participate. And there we shall, so this is the work in progress. We are trying to deal with these subjects also on academic, scientific way. And we are publishing much more articles in the last years. Like my article will be now in the Academy of Management Journal on art and leadership in our school published. This was by invitation, so I was very proud and happy that this most important organization in the world in our field is recognizing that. We have in our MBA, for instance, seven to eight days of art and leadership. We have about 20 days on leadership. We are very much focused, but from these 20 days of leadership education, we have 8 days on art and leadership. We use music. We have a professional pianist since 5 years already employed in the school, a Canadian, who is a professional pianist, but also a doctor of science in organizational behavior. So the right person to explain that and to look for the, not only parallels, but really what, as you use the word reflection, we are letting people reflect, letting them inspire, letting them go much deeper than just to look for the parallels. For instance, I shall give some example. We are really helping to students to learn from metaphors. Metaphors are very strong in art especially. Like learning from the music metaphor, you become better listener. You can see on Beethoven's sonata where the change management happened. Beethoven, for instance, was a big innovator in the music. So you can see that, how he made a change management in his music. You can see in visual arts, how you can become, if you are looking to paintings on a, you know, in a careful way, how you can really become, learn to become better observer. And being a good observer and being a good listener is extremely important skill for every leader and every manager. So we have also, we are also bringing students through other art processes to see how their creativity and then on the basis of creativity their innovation can be boosted. So I can say it's for me, as somebody who initiated this process, and for the people who participate, for instance, we have theater director, film director, musician, I mentioned already, some musicians we have, visual artist, etc. We are, and even ballet and so on, we are really doing something very, very special. I can perhaps finish about that to tell you another example. Recently we had Austrian, we have a lot of Austrians in our school, and we had recently a seminar for an Austrian bank, very in big problems, the bank in problems. And then they were like 800-900 people sending to us. In half an hour we educated, you know, everybody from middle management to the top management. And then at the end they said to us, now we finish this big circle, you know, this big educational program. Can you do something innovative for a big finale? And we said, yes, of course. And my colleague wrote, I don't know whether it was comedy or drama, it was both of it. He was writing a scenario in three acts for the theater play in three acts. And there were two actors playing, and it was, they were using the words, the expressions of these bankers, and it was such a fantastic end because they were recognizing their own behaviors in this play. And it was much more, you know, emotional engagement is so important. This I forgot to mention. You know, you can expect a change in the organization only if people change emotionally. And then you can really expect something that it will change also in organization. So art is very much helping to bring this change up and to make a great, create a great impact on the human being. And I have to say that our school is built like an art gallery. We say that we are a creative environment for creative leadership. So you are getting inspiration from the morning till the evening you are there, also through the environment and through the fact that you are there and that you can have a view on beautiful sculptures, beautiful paintings, and you can really go inspired home. And for me, only this counts in management education, the change. If this and the impact, if the school creates an impact, then not only I learned a lot, but I got a lot. I had a fantastic experience. This is for me very important, and I believe that your business school is also striving for the similar results.